Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we honor the flags of Monaco, the UIM, and the IOC with the national anthem of Monaco. Gentlemen, you may be seated. Good evening and a very special welcome to all our honored guests for what will be a magnificent night here in Monaco as we welcome you to the third annual UIM Awards Giving Gala ceremony, our main event here in Monaco at the Salle des Étoiles, the Room of the Stars. I'm Steve Michael, and to my right and joining me this year for the first time is the lovely Savina Confalani of Italy, and who is a TV journalist, by the way, as well as a rally driver. Now, she raced here just a week ago at the Monaco Rally, and a wonderful driver I know you are. Dear Savina, it's a pleasure to have you here tonight.
Yeah, thank you, Steve. Good evening. Good evening to everybody. It's a real pleasure and honor to be with you tonight.
Well, we're going to be your co-host for the evening and Masters of Ceremonies and for the evening, and we are truly honored, first of all, to be here. First of all, we'd like to make a special salute to our international promoters, partners, and sponsors. And because of their efforts, because of their passion, they were celebrating for us here this 108th anniversary year of the sport of powerboat racing in 2012.
This year we will celebrate our world champions, the environmental award winners, and we will honor the outstanding behavior. But now, please, I want to hear all of you to applaud with great enthusiasm all the promoters, partners, and sponsors who are with us tonight.
Well, this is a special place. This is a special evening. And tonight we will honor a very elite group of individuals who have reached the ultimate in their prospective category, our world champions. So let's begin and bring up on the spotlight of the evening as I introduce a man who is a real leader and innovator, whose important agreements and acknowledgments has brought a new and dynamic realization of the sport of powerboat racing.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, our UIM president, Dr. Raffaele Chiulli.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, UIM World Champions, Powerboating Friends. As President of the International Powerboating Federation, I'm delighted to be here with you all at this very special UIM Awards Giving Gala. Let me thank you for having accepted our invitation and for your continuous support of our sport, and special thanks to the UIM Secretary General, Andrea Dini, which is there, and to the UIM office team. for their remarkable effort in organizing this event. I'm pleased that our world champions are present tonight from throughout the world. This evening has brought together more than 30 different nations, and many champions have chosen to be accompanied by their national authorities delegate, their sponsors, and their friends who will share this memorable evening with all of us. As president of the UIM, I'm committed to making our federation more relevant to our sport. And as part of this changing process, I'm delighted to be here this evening with you all at the third UIM award ceremony and share together the pride of our world champions. We are also very pleased to acknowledge all the sponsors and business partners who have joined forces with the UIM to support this initiative. Let me also share my pride for having been re-elected as president of our prestigious institution. This has reinforced my commitment to continue to serve our union and you all in setting and achieving new challenging goals. In the last year, the UIM strategic approach brought a significant change to our sport and certainly contributed to our outstanding achievements. At the last UIM Open Forum and General Assembly, we had the opportunity to share the UIM roadmap and strategic plan and to review objectives, work in progress, and accomplishment. It was the opinion of all those who attended and the International Olympic Committee that the UIM is becoming increasingly successful, has carried out significant changes in power boating, and that we together are delivering on our promises. I want to underline that. We are delivering on our promises together. It is worth mentioning that last year, 2011 season, in over 50 countries around the world, powerboat racing had been organized under the UIM leadership, with 170 UIM titled events and 60 UIM World Championship titles awarded to our racers who proudly waved the UIM flag. In order to establish powerboating as a powerful sporting movement, we will continue to be focusing on the development of young talents. And we officially presented our UIM Youth Development Program at the Düsseldorf Boat Show very recently, last month. Düsseldorf is one of the most prominent boat shows worldwide, as you all know. The UIM is continuing to support all junior classes in their development of young talent. We are and we will be fully committed to growing the sport to secure a bright future for our teams. You can see over there the UIM training boats, which will be used for our junior racing activities. We are really proud of that. These are UIM training boats. I'm glad to say that we are further strengthening our activities in communication and marketing, and new sponsors and partners, believing in our core values and principles, are joining forces with the UIM. And I'm sure more will join in the future, in line with our motto, get to know us, you will like us, and support us. We are working hard on environment, alternative energies, and sustainable development. Also with the other leading motorsport bodies, such as FIA, International Car Federation, FIM, International Motorcycling Federation, FI, International Aerosport Federation, and with the International Water Ski and Wakeboard Federation. And this in line with the cooperation agreement that the UIM signed with the United Nations Environment Programme. To emphasize the significance and focus on sustainable development, the UIM produced and adopted the environmental code, established the prestigious UIM Awards, which will be assigned tonight. On environment and energy efficiency, we are also developing significant synergies between both the art industry and competitive power voting. I think all of you who were with me this afternoon at the press conference concretely saw how the nautical industry is becoming more relevant to competitive power voting and vice versa. To me, what we had this afternoon, just a few hours ago, here at the press conference is something to be certainly remembered. Safety will continue to be among the main UIM priorities, and we are committed to continuously improve. We will soon be meeting with FIA, and I'm proud that we have the Vice President with us this evening of FIA at their premises in Paris to share knowledge and experience on safety, particularly on seat belts and helmets, as well as on several key environmental aspects. And this why? Because it was requested at the racing events, but some of our racers that told me, Mr. President, we have to learn from our International Sport Federation and we don't have to reinvent the wheel. This was immediately implemented, and so we are going to meet next month and share the knowledge and share the expertise with the leading motorsport federation. As an active and loyal member of the Olympic family, at the UIM, we dream that our young athletes will be soon part of the Youth Olympic Games, because as you know, our flag is already flying at the IOC in Lausanne, together with all the main World Sport Federation. And as a gesture of goodwill, as you've seen tonight, the IOC sent us their flag to endorse this event. This has been highly appreciated by our federation. So it's a sign of goodwill from the IOC. We will continue to work exactly into that direction. Let me now thank and congratulate our 2011 World Champions, their national authorities and organizing clubs, all teams and drivers, the sponsors, the UIM contracted promoters, and our UIM officials for their involvement at a very high professional level. I would like to conclude with my most sincere thanks to our passionate fans and friends, and to all the people who gave their remarkable contribution to our sport, particularly the ones who did it on a voluntary basis, and wish you all a safe and successful racing season. Enjoy this evening. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Also, this UIM Awards Giving Gala, in its short time, it has become such a good and great tradition thanks to the effort imparted by the Federation, but it has been only possible with the help of our supporters, partners, and sponsors, of course. Abu Dhabi Marine Sports Club. Peters and May. E-Docs, H2O Racing Powerboat Promotion, Powerboat P1 Superstock, Free Time Luxury Lifestyle, Marine Pool, Victory, and Buon Amico. And of course, still my last but not least, all the persons which helped put together this great event. So thanks a lot to everyone. Now let's begin the award ceremony with the first group. And let's first of all ask to join us on stage Jean-Marie Van Lenker, UIM Council member, to award the winners. Thank you. Okay, let's start with the circuit endurance thematics. Class 1, the world champions are Dimitri Vandyshev, Roman Vandyshev, and Armen Yezayan from Russia.
We start with a three-man Russian team headed by the Vandashev family, with the older Dmitry winning his first world championship 9 years ago, and in 2011 with another triumph, marking his fifth world title. And younger Roman and teammate Armin capturing their second. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, your first champions of the evening, Dmitry and Roman Vandashev, together with Armin Yassayan, the Circuit Endurance Pneumatics Chef 1 World Champion.
Yeah, here they are, the new Endurance Pneumatic Class 1 World Champions, Dmitry Vandashev, Roman Vandashev, and Armin Yassayan. Thank you. Now, let's wait the pictures to get to an end.
Got a lot of media here tonight.
Yes, of course.
Which is nice.
Very good. Okay, now the Endurance Pneumatics Class 2 category. The world champions are Andrzej Dudax and Dmitry Schiller from Latvia and Andrei Leontiev from the Russian Federation.
Well, this racing trio has had a diverse lifestyle away from the sport, with Dmitry Schiller being a scuba diving instructor. Meanwhile, Andre is a TV journalist producing and also appearing on camera. While Andres is the team mechanic that keeps important things together. Here they are, the new Circuit Endurance Pneumatics Class 2 champions, Andres Dudax, Dmitry Schiller from Latvia, and Andre Leonetov from Russia.
So, the 2011 UIM Endurance Pneumatics Class 2 World Champions are Andrei Leontiev from Russia, Andrei Dudax, and Dmitry Schiller from the Russian Federation. Thanks again.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Really, congratulations, champions. Now the stage is ready for Circuit Endurance Pneumatics Class 3. The world champions are Sergei Kryashev, Boris Efimkon, Vladimir Svetoshov, and Stanislav Matveev of Russia.
This is another group of four drivers from the Russian Federation reaching the big time for the first time. Sergei has had a busy summer watching his own daughter, Anastasia, win the European title and finish runner-up in the Formula Future title in 2011, while father Sergei has also registered a world championship back in 2007 in the Class 1 series. Here they are, Sergei, Kryashev, Boris, Dymovkin, Vladimir Svetsetskov, and Stanislav Matveev, your new Circuit Endurance Pneumatics Class 3 world champion.
Good, here they are, the 2011 UIM Endurance Pneumatics Class 3 World Champions. Very good, guys, and I'm so sorry for my pronunciations, but your names are so difficult.
Spasiba, gentlemen, spasiba.
Yeah, well, now I would call on stage Mr. Jesse Chesko, UIM Vice President, and Erwin Lange, UIM Council Member. Circuit Endurance of Pneumatics Category Class 4, the world champions are Yuri Smirnov, Alexander Smirnov, and Ivan Pilev from Russia.
Led by a living legend, ladies and gentlemen, 75 years young, Yuri Smirnov, who along with his son Alexander captured victories in the 24-hour White Knights Endurance event last July in St. Petersburg, winning the European Championship in June in Riga, Latvia. Yuri, who has won four world titles and is an inspiration to all retirees around the world. Here they are, the crew of combined age of 138 years young and still going strong. Yuri Smirnov, Alexander Smirnov, and Ivan Pilev from Russia. By the way, Ivan is 50 years younger.
Fun group of drivers that just keep on racing year after year still. Yurian Alexander Smirnov, joined, I repeat, by Ivan Pilev, your Circuit Endurance Pneumatics Class 4 World Champions. Very good. And now, it's time to change the category. We are to Circuit Class 0125. And the world champion is, that's easier for me to pronounce because he comes from Italy, Alex Zilioli.
Well, yes, for the second time in 3 years, an Italian has taken the crown in this exciting class. And this driver did not disappoint, coming home with the glory after a tremendous run at the Water Festival held in Hungary last summer. He enjoys karting, snowmobiling, but his real love is powerboat racing, and he showed it this past season by becoming world champion. The winner of the UIM Circuit 0125 class is 27-year-old Alexei Zilioli from Italy.
Very good, sir. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I must remind that these confirmed world champions of Circuit 0125. And now, we're up to class 0175, 0250, and 0350. Why together? Because the triple world champion is René Benke from Germany. So three titles.
Well, I'll tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. He is a gifted driver from Germany who has a special place in the history of this sport, who continues to dominate not only in the 0250 class, which he has won now for the past 3 years, but the 0175, where he just won two of the past three summers, and for the first time, 0350. Three world titles in 1 year. Everybody put your hands together, a special man, a triple world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, from Germany, René Benke.
Yeah, a lot of trophies headed this way. Indeed, three trophies for René Benke, who is a rare three-class winner in 1 year of racing for the 32-year-old driver. Thank you, René Benke. Really good year you had. And now I would ask to Mr. Ivan Motta, who is the UIM Council member, to join me on the stage. Very good. So, Circuit 0700, the world champion is Attila Havas from Austria.
Well, the next driver is back to collect his second straight world championship trophy, ladies and gentlemen. A native of Budapest who drives for the Sport Club of Austria, first racing in Hungary back in 1986, winning the OSH title for the first time in racing for him. No stranger to the pressures of the spotlight of winning, capturing 12 world titles, 50 UIM podium medals, and still pushing for more. Ladies and gentlemen, from Hungary, driving for Austria, this year's world champion in the UIM Circuit 0700 class, Attila Havas.
Attila Havas is back on stage and back in Monaco for a second straight year as champion of this 0700 class. And now we are to class OSY 400. The world champion is Sten Kalder from Estonia.
Well, the lovely country of Estonia is represented here tonight for the first time with a driver who has won a world title before in the JT250 class in 2008, has moved up to a very exciting OSY 400 machine. Ladies and gentlemen, winning from Estonia the OSY 400 title for the first time in maybe many years, Sten Kalder, now the multi-time world champion. Congratulations.
Sten Kalder is the new OSY 400 UIM world champion from Estonia, so compliments to him as well. The last pictures, and then we'll move to the youngsters. Very good. As I said, let's move to the youngsters of our sport. They are our future stars of Formula Future. Class 5 world champion is Georgi Kasimov from Russia.
Here's a very talented driver who at 17 years old is back to collect another world title. Just 2 years ago, he won the Class 4 championship, and here he is again. Having started racing when he was just 8 years old, he is almost a fish out of water. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the past year's UIM Circuit Formula Future Class 5 Award from Russia, Georgi Kasimov.
So, another Russian pilot, Georgi Kasimov, congratulations to you. And now I would ask Mr. Christos Gustafsson, UIM Council member, to join me on the stage. So thank you to Mr. Ivan Motta. Now it's your turn, Mr. Christer Gustafsson, Formula Future Class 4 Division. Very good. The world champion is Anastasia Varlamova from Russia.
This 15-year-old Russian woman has her sights firmly set on the future. Very worldly, she speaks 3 languages and she's working on her 4th language. She loves snowboarding and in the winter actually started playing tennis when she was just 4 years old, but had to choose between that and powerboat racing. And your winner of the UIM Circuit Formula Future Class 4 World Champion, Anastasia Varlamova from Russia.
Such a nice lady in a great sport. Unbelievable, really beautiful. Anastasia went from 14th in the world title in 2010 to take the title this year. So really congratulations. And since she's a woman, another applause. Good, now we are up to Formula Future Class 3. Formula Future Class 3, the world champion is Timofey Nikitin from Russia.
Well, the Russian Federation has a bright future. And continuing this trend is a young 13-year-old boy who has been already racing for 8 years, since he was 5 years old. Let's meet him, winning his first world title after taking a European crown back in 2009. Ladies and gentlemen, your new UIM Circuit Formula Future Class 3 world champion is Timofey Nikitin from Russia.
Can you imagine? Timofey has been racing a long time, even though he's only 13 years old, and it looks like he has a bright future ahead of me, really.
Great to start him young.
Really? So thank you, and now we move to Formula Future Class 2. Formula Future Class 2, the world champion is Julia Yurchenko from Russia.
Well, the heart of powerboat racing begins with the youth, carrying on a legacy of this sports institution. So let's meet the driver that took the title in Moscow region last summer. And when not racing, enjoys snowboarding, sport dance, and chess. By the way, a fantastic chess player, went to the infamous chess school. Here in your future Class 2 category winner, she put the checkmate on the competition, ladies and gentlemen, all summer, Julia Yurchenko from Russia.
Well, a busy 10-year-old, your new Formula Future Class 2 champion. And now, please, I call on stage our president, Dr. Raffaele Chiulli, because now we are giving awards to Formula Future Class 1. The world champion is Maxim Pikhotin from Russia.
This young Russian did it in style, having raced in the not getting his feet wet in the race boat, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet some of the young blood and the power of this powerboat racing world champion circuit for the Formula Future Class 1 category. Maxime Peacock team from Russia.
So there you have it. Our fifth and final Formula Future class for the evening, and of course another Russian getting the award from our president. So thank you, Mr. President, thank you, Maxime. Hope to see you again, of course, for several more years. And now it's time to take a quick break as we bring to you a touch of beauty and a touch of style. We will see a spectacular défilé honoring most of the flags of UIM affiliate countries. Now we will have really nice dresses with nice cities painted on them. It's a special project by Antonella Ferrari, EPIC's president. So, musica maestro! Thank you, everyone, and well, so you see you again later. There will be another part of a défilé. And now I want you, please, to join me on the stage, Mr. Ugur Izik, UIM Council member, to start with the next awards. So, Mr. Ugur Izik. And let's start with the circuit endurance categories. Class 1 world champion is Jérôme Amédé from France.
Well, the French have always had a history of being strong in this category, and this year is again no exception. Begin talking about the 44-year-old father, who is the father of two, has been racing for over 10 years and is truly engulfed in the sport. His team got it all right in 2011. And to win their coveted world title, the year winners of the UIM Circuit Endurance Class 1 category, led by Jérôme Amédé of France.
Thank you. Our new Endurance Class 1 world champion is the first one from France, Jérôme Amédé. Thank you. And Mr. Ukwezik, let's stay with us. Yeah, because now our second class, endurance class two. The world champion is Eric Doublet from France.
Well, if there's a legend in the circuit endurance class, it would be our next recipient. He has won this title 7 consecutive years. And rival partner and now friend Frank Labar, who has been able to enjoy all the fun in the past 3 seasons. Ari continues to roll on, and his talent is mixed with consistency, proving that if you are prepared and you can conquer the world year after year, if you're willing to make sacrifices, that takes you to get there. The winner of the UIM Circuit Endurance Class 2 title, Ari Doublet of France.
Yeah, consistent winner year after year in this Endurance Class 2 Championship, Eric Doublet. And now, Circuit S, 550 class, the world champion is Ott Juala from Estonia.
Well, the lovely country of Estonia gets represented for the second time this evening. A 24-year-old driver proved that he was ready to take the top step since he first began racing back in 2003 in the JT 250 class. This is the first world title, and he is elated. When he gets not glued watching football matches on TV, he loves to go racing. Your winner in the UIM Circuit S 550 class is Ott Juala from Estonia.
Good. You're world champion in S 550. And please now, I would ask Mr. Dieter Kom, UIM Council member, to join the stage. So thank you to Mr. Uwe Isek. Now it's up to Mr. Dieter Kom. And the next award is for Circuit F4S. So, Circuit F4S, the world champion is Martin Marotz from Latvia.
This is one of the newer and most exciting classes to run on the water, which has become a real hit in Northern Europe as well as North America. Here's another driver who started in the JT 250 and worked his way up to the 4S class. Persistence was the name of the game as this driver, who had finished twice before in the top 5 in the World Championship, finally came home with a trophy. Your new world champion in the UIM Circuit 4S class, Martins Maros of Latvia.
All of them, they are so young, Steve. He is 19 years old, so Martin Maros. And now back to the youngsters. Circuit JT 250, the world champion is Maximilian Tukovs from Latvia.
Another budding teenager who has a great future ahead of him is also from Latvia. He came away with the coveted world title in a very competitive class. And when winter sets in, he loves the competition of ice hockey on frozen water. He also loves downhill skiing, but his real love is powerboat racing when the weather warms up. Your winner in the UIM Circuit JT 250 class is 14-year-old Maximilian Tukovs from Latvia.
14 years old, huh? From Latvia. Very good. And now it's a very special trophy to be given out the next two classes. So I would ask to our president, so Dr. Raffaele Chiuli, if he can come back to our stage as he presents this new and exciting Abu Dhabi trophy. Thank you, Mr. Chiuli. So now Circuit GT15. The world champion is Ben Jelf from Great Britain.
If family lineage has anything to do with talent, we are seeing firsthand here a young driver who comes from the sport after his father and uncle have proved so many times that they have the talent and drive to be multi-time world champions themselves. Feeling the pressure? Maybe. Letting affect him? Not hardly. As we bring to you the UIM Circuit GT15 World Champion from Great Britain and a new star on the horizon, is Ben Jelf, ladies and gentlemen.
Vangelf, hoping to carry on the grand tradition of three generations of racers in his family. So, really a great heritage of winning in the serpent. Now, no Mr. Cuny stay here with us. The Presidente non se ne vada, perché deve premiare anche la prossima categoria. Now, circuit GT30. The world champion is Christian Carlsen from Norway.
Well, the lovely country of Norway is being well represented tonight, as the 17-year-old driver has only been racing for 3 years, and already he's got a world title. He won the German championship in 2010. He's an avid water skier and downhill skier in the snow as well. Third in the European Championship, but more importantly, the UIM Circuit GT30 title for 2011. Christian Carlsen from Norway.
Very good. Christian Carlsen, your new Circuit GT30 champion. Thank you, Mr. President.
And go back
thank
and
you,
now.
Christian, of course. And now it's time to call on stage Sami Abu Shaika, UIM Council Member, Circuit H1. We are to the Circuit H1. The world champion is Scott Lidcote from United States.
This veteran driver has raced in every kind of inboard hydroplane class in the American Powerboat Association in his 20 years of racing, including 20 different hulls. This man is starting back his first race, winning the 2002 New Jersey State Championship in 2.5 liter stocks, and he's moved up to capturing the now famous Orcs Cup, running the unlimited hydroplanes in Doha, Qatar. Born in Canada, but now makes his home in Suffolk, Virginia, from the USA, Scott Lidcote, your UIM Circuit H1 World Champion.
The 40-year-old Scott Lidcote is our UIM Circuit H1 World Champion from the southern state of Virginia. Your compatriot, huh?
Y'all better believe it, honey.
Yeah.
Y'all better believe it.
So now we are up to Circuit Formula 500. The world champion is Marian Young from Slovakia.
A country of over 5 million people that has a rich racing tradition and very talented ice hockey team in the past years as well. Winning his second time in the last 3 years as your 2009 title holder, now winning it again in 2011, your UIM Circuit Formula 500 World Champion from Slovakia, Marian Young.
Marian Young from Slovakia continues to be a factor in Formula 500 class, winning the title for the second time. And now I thank you, Mr. Sami Abu Shaika, and I ask to join us on the stage Mr. Giacomo Borgonovi, UIM Council Member, and again, I'm sorry, Mr. Raffaele Chiuli, our President again.
Si.
Circuit Formula 2. So, Circuit Formula 2, the world champion is Eric Stark from Sweden.
Well, a driver that I've personally known for a while, who is a tremendous talent, who's been racing for over a decade. Even though he's only 24 years old, he started his success winning in the Swedish title in the S250 class back in 2002. He is a four-time winner of the Formula 2 World Tour in 2011, won the match race in Poland. I'll tell you something, he's a great person, fantastically talented driver, your UIM Circuit Formula 2 World Champion from Sweden, Eric Stark.
And Eric Stark wins the Formula 2 title, and we'll see more of him a little later. Thanks to Eric Stark, and I ask Mr. Giacomo Borgonovi and Raffaele Chiuli to stay on the stage, because now we are ready to the awards for the Circuit Formula One. Well, Circuit Formula One. The world champion is Alex Carella from Team Qatar.
Well, a pilot who in only his second year in just 15 official race starts came from behind in 2011, winning defeating his own teammate, who was the 2008 world champion. Easy with him there. And capture his first UIM Formula One World Championship title himself, winning twice in Kazan and also Abu Dhabi, becoming the 10th different Italian driver to win a Formula One Grand Prix title in the sport's four decades of racing. Your 2011 UIM Formula One H2O World Champion is first, what many people expect to be many times, Alex Carella from Italy, driving for the Qatar team.
Yeah, all of Italy knows Alex Carella. You're a 2011 UIM One World Champion. Many congratulations, of course, and many more titles. And now, let's take a break and start things off by showing you a great 12-minute video presentation, the third issue of The Best of Power Boating, summarizing the 2011 season. So let's watch this amazing video. Let's change to a totally different form of racing, to the always exciting aquabike classes. I call on stage Jean-Marie Lhomme, where I am council member. So please, Mr. Jean-Marie Lhomme. And we'll start with the Pro Ski Women F1. The world champion is Julie Bolto from France.
Well, the definition of a world domination is pretty clearly cut, ladies and gentlemen. Supremacy over another, exercise or mastery of a ruling power. And Julie Bolto of France has done just this, not for days, not for weeks, but she's been doing this for years. At 24 years young, she is third straight year as the number one in her sport. Ladies and gentlemen, here she is, the UIM Aquabike Class Pro Ski World Women's Formula One title holder from France, Julie Bolto.
Well done for Julie Bolto, a three-time world champion in the Aquabike Class Pro Ski Division for women. And now, Aquabike Class Pro Runabout F1. The world champion is a gentleman from Italy, Mattia Fracasso.
Well, here's a rider who saved his very best for last, winning his final two events in China to capture and come from behind and take a world championship. 21 years old, who won three of the Series 8 events, and he loves working out in judo and boxing, so don't mess with this guy. So fighting his way to a UIM Aquabike Class Pro Runabout F1 title from Italy, Mattia Fracasso.
Mattia Fracasso is your new Aquabike Class Pro Runabout F1 World title holder. And now, Ski Division F1. Ski Division F1, the world champion is Jeremy Poré from France.
Jeremy came storming out of the gate and ended up winning five of the eight races, including taking the critical final two events to capture the overall title when it was said and done. The sport just seems to come easily for he and his family, and the desire continues to ring deep. The winner of the 2011 UIM Aquabike Class Pro Ski Division F1 from France, Jeremy Poré.
So for the second time in 3 years, a Poré brother wins the title. Tonight is Jeremy Poré. And now I would ask again, Mr. President Raffaele Chiuli, to join us on the stage. And I please also Mr. Giacomo Borgonovi, who I am council member, to join us. We are to the Aquabike Class Pro Freestyle. The world champion is Valerio Calderoni from Italy.
Well, you gotta love this guy. One aspect of Aquabike Series that really gets the crowd on their feet is the pro freestyle event. It's a real show, and the rider who won this back-to-back title, he lost it a year ago, however, and now is a two-time winner, charging back from the final few events in 2011, and became number one again, a real showman from Italy, your UIM Aquabike Class Pro Freestyle World Champion, Valerio Showtime Calderoni.
So the UIM Aquabike Class Pro Freestyle World Champion comes from Rome, Italy, our Valerio Calderoni. And I would ask to Mr. President to stay with us. And thank you, Giacomo Borgonovi. And I would ask the H2O promoter, Mr. Nicolò Di San Germano, to join us on the stage. So Mr. Nicolò Di San Germano with Mr. Raffaele Chiulli will stay on the stage, because we are to the Aquabike Rally Jet. World champion is Teddy Pons from France.
Well, to win the Rally Jet prize, you have to be the leading rider of a field of over 50 drivers who race out in the open ocean for 3 days in any kind of weather last year on the Caribbean island chain of Guadeloupe. In a giant struggle between an American rider and other top riders, the Frenchman came home strong, winning after the three-day event. Ladies and gentlemen, your UIM Aquabike Rally Jet World Champion is, from France, Teddy Pons.
Very good. Teddy Pons, the final winner in the UIM Aquabike division in Rally Jet. And now, see, we are up to a very important moment.
And now we want to take a few moments to dedicate our time. And we're going to ask Andrea Dini, who is now the General Secretary of the UIM, and who has hosted this event with me for the last 2 years. Andrea, would you step forward, please? It's your time, my friend. Here we go for the Stefano Casaraghi Memorial Trophy, given in recognition of special service to the sport and to whom in their career has done something in improving and developing our sport. Together with the Sam Griffith Trophy that is here on stage, the most coveted trophy in UIM history. Andrea?
Good evening. Now it's time for the Stefano Casiraghi Memorial Trophy, a special trophy which UIM created 2 years ago in order to recognize special service to our sport and to whom in their career have done something in improving and developing our sport. You can see the Stefano Casiraghi Memorial Trophy there on your right, together with the Sam Griffith Trophy, the most coveted trophy in the UIM history. Now please, you can join us on the stage in order to award this trophy, Mr. Marco Casiraghi, please. The Italian ambassador in Monaco Principality, His Excellency Antonio Morabito. The UIM President, Dr. Raffaele Chiulli. And Fabio Ravenna, remembering his father. This trophy is to be given to a person whose in his career has done something special in improving and developing power boating. This year, UIM decided to award the Stefano Casiraghi Memorial Trophy to a man who has dedicated most of his career in improving the sport of powerboating. This year, the Stefano Casiraghi Memorial Trophy is for Said Areb.
Said, Dottor. First, I would like to thank UIM family. Thank for Dr. Rabea Kiuli. Here a second time for me. I am here was 1990 as the youngest member in the UIM. That day, I met Kiuli and we start together. From that day, 1990, we worked together to improve the water sport in general. I'm very sorry, I miss one of the important friends. He start with me here. I'm sorry he's not with us, but his son is here. Everyone know and remember, and we don't forget this guy called Mauro Ravenna. Thank you. He's one of the, he put the first step to be start the class one in Dubai. I remember that 1992. We have a meeting here and he asked me, can we organize class one? I said, yes, we can do it. And we start. From that day, I keep going and coming and we built good relation and can say today that UIM grow better and better than before. I can see the number of the family, the number of the faces, the new generation, the old generation mixed together for to target for UIM. Thank you, UIM family. Thank you, Kiuli. I am very, very proud today to receive the trophy. That's not for me only because there is someone support me in the past to be here. Support me personally. I lost her. She's my wife. And this trophy will go to the soul of my wife. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I think there was no better choice this year than award the Memorial Stefano Casiraghi Trophy to you. And your words will remain with us for many, many months and years. I have next to me a person to whom I promise that we as UIM will do every day the maximum we can to continue to improve continuously our safety for the sport. And this is Mauro Casiraghi, which is the brother of Stefano. And be sure, until I will be the president of this union, I will honor my commitment with you. Okay? And I have to say another thing. We have Fabio Ravenna. Fabio is the son of Mauro Ravenna, which is in the heart of all of us who lost his life recently, but we will continue to have Mauro, as Said said before, as our reference point. The values and the principles that we have in our heart will never disappear. Mauro will continue to be with us, Fabio. And I leave the word to you, please, before.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm really proud to participate to this award to Mr. Said Areb. I remember 20 years ago in Dubai, we started to organize the Class 1 powerboat, and he's the man who organized more powerboat events in the world. And so I'm proud once again, as I told you before, we share something with Mauro, because Mauro likes him very much.
very glad to be here in this magnificent evening, congratulating the president, great Italian Raffaele Giulli, congratulating the Secretary General Andrea Bini. I think for Italy, this sport, the International Union of Motonautica, is something part of our history, part of our sport, of our heart. And the fact that more and more is becoming international, we celebrate the Russian celebrities, the people from every part of the world, the Germans, the Sweden, very, very, more and more international, more and more committed in safety, in the memory of Stefano Casiraghi. I think for Italy is the best success that we can have with you all together.
Thank you, gentlemen. And now, it's time for the UIM Environmental Award. The UIM Environmental Award has been launched in order to inspire and recognize excellence in innovation, development and application of environmentally friendly techniques. It's open to the UIM national authorities, partners, racing teams, boat builders, engine manufacturers, universities, research centers, scientists, non-government organizations. It's open for a lot of people, and I'll tell you something, the companies to recognize their outstanding environmental leadership, whether individuals or organizations that have exemplified, inspired their vision, their innovation, their leadership, and the applications for the environment. Among the main selection criteria are innovation, significance, practicality, usability, economic feasibility, and environmental benefits.
Well done, Stephen. Thank you. Now it's time to award the Environmental Award for 2011. Please, I ask to join us on the stage Mr. Bahur Yohala, member of the Environmental Working Group. Bahur? The special mention for economic feasibility go to Mercury Racing, Brunswick Corporation. Please, if join, Mary De Martini can join us on the stage. Video. Special mention for economic visibility was for Mercury Racing. Thank you, Vaud. Now let's switch to environmental benefit. Please, if Mr. Mohamed Arib can join us on the stage to hand over this trophy. The 2011 UIM Environmental Award special mention for environmental benefit go to Planet Solar Project. Receive the trophy, Mr. Pascal Gulpier. Thank you. special mention for environmental benefit was for Planet Solar. Now, let's switch to special mention for innovation. I kindly ask Mr. Riccardo Ballesio, Environmental Working Group Chairman, to join us on the stage to award the next special mention. Please, Riccardo. The 2011 UIM Environmental Award Special Mention for Innovation go to Frauscher Shipyard. Receive the trophy, Mr. Stefan Frauscher, CEO for Sales and Marketing of this Austrian shipyard. For Innovation 2011 UIM Environmental Award. UIM 2011 Environmental Award winner. I kindly ask to join us on the stage Mr. Stefan Novak, International Energy Agency Chairman of Photovoltaic Power Program, and Dr. Raffaele Chiulli. The 2011 UIM Environmental Award winner is Azimut Yachts with Azimut Magellano 50, Azimut Benetti Group. Please, Mr. Francesco Alzalone, Marketing Director of Azimut Benetti Group, receive this trophy.
Awards. I'm very proud to be here and that such a recognition was given to the company that I represent tonight. Thank you again.
Well, I would like to congratulate you on this wonderful innovation and you both you have done. I'm working in solar energy and as you can see from my tie, and I would never have thought to join you in such an event tonight. When I started in this field 20 years ago, and this was very far for me. And 2 days ago only, I was in one of the most prestigious engine filters laboratories to see what they are doing. And tonight I'm here at the UIM ceremony, and I can see that environmental concerns are coming in more and more, and that makes me very respectful and respectful for the future. Thank you very much and congratulations.
Stefan, let me just say that we are proud to have here tonight one of the leading worldwide shipyard industry like the Azimut Group, but we are also very honored to have you here as the chairman of the International Energy Agency photovoltaic sector, and we know that you are very rigorous, we know that you are watching us, we will try to match your expectation. Thank you very much.
Good. Thank you to Andrea Dini. Thanks a lot. And now let's back to the beauty and the charm of our beautiful models as we present for the final time our défilé dedicated to the countries and cities. This spectacular painted dress is the opera of Antonella Ferrari, Epic's president. So, music on stage, please. Musica.
Take my eyes and look around. Take my ears and listen to the stars. This is what you are. Knock me down, knock me out, make me feel shy. But when you hold me in your arms, I can just forget the tears I cry. This is what you are. Write your number on my wall, say you gotta do. Call your shadow on my soul, even when you break my heart in two. This is what you are. Light on, this is what you are. Shine a light in the light. Thank you.
different countries. So we have France, Tahiti, Paris. So we have all the most beautiful towns in the world. And now with this beauty, we finished this fashion part of the evenings, and we will go back soon to the awards. Actually, we're almost over, aren't we? Yeah.
Yeah, it's
so thanks again to our wonderful ladies. And we are back to the awards, and I asked in the meantime Mr. Frode Sundstahl, who I'm council member, to join us. So Mr. Frode Sundstahl, please join us, because now we are giving the award to the Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group B Class Pro. The world champion is Gian Maria Gappiani from Italy.
Well, here's a professional racer who can shift attention from rubber meeting the road. The props, slicing up the water on one ink weekend to another. This professional race car driver, who is reigning Italian touring car champion, put his attention into the powerboat racing last summer at a very high level and came away with the world title at the age of 33. So, on and off the water, your 2011 UIM Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group Three Class Pro winner from Italy, Gian Maria Gappiani.
Yes, so Gian Maria Gappiani gets his feet wet in a good way, winning the Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group B Class Pro title. And now, Pleasure Navigation Group B Boat Production. The world champion is another Italian gentleman, Maurizio Carando.
Maurizio has been racing since he was 13 years old and has tried a myriad of classes in the offshore and endurance classes. But staying on top and being number one is always difficult. But he did it again and again this year, and your winner in the UIM Endurance Group B Boat Production class from Northern Italy. Yes, Maurizio Carando.
Good, Maurizio Carando is back for a second straight year in the Endurance Group B Boat Production class. Congratulations, and now, thank you, Mr. Frodsonstal. Now I have to call on stage Mr. Yunis Lukmanov, UIM council member. And we are to the Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group B Class S1 World Champions. So the World Champions Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group B Class S1 is Eugenio Falcon and Victor Rivero from Spain.
Well, Genie's first Spanish championship came back in the two-liter offshore class in 1995, including a 27-hour event around Seven Islands in 2002. However, in 2011, has both been pilot's crowning jewel because the ladies and gentlemen, for the first time at the UIM World Championship, Elenio Falcone and Victor Rivero, the new Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group B Class S1 World Titleist for 2011.
Spanish pilots Eugenio Falcon and Victor Rivero, your new Endurance Group B Class S1 champions. Good, thank you. And now, Pleasure Navigation Endurance Group B Class S2, the world champion is Lucio Stefani from Italy.
Back for the second straight season is a well-deserving Italian who has a large five-boat team with a stable of different drivers, proving to everyone he has the best in class, winning for back-to-back champions and a very competitive and exciting class, the UIM Pleasure Boat Navigation Endurance Group B Class 2, going to Lucio Stefani of Italy.
Thank you. Lucio champion in Italy went for a second straight year in the Andreas World Champion Group B Class S2. And now, thank you, Mr. Lukmanov. I want to call on stage Mr. Andrea Dini, our UIM Secretary General, along with Enrico Gelpi, FIA Vice President. So, Mr. Andrea Dini and Mr. Enrico Gelpi together on the stage. Thank you. And we talk about offshore. Let's begin by bringing up the offshore class 3-225. The world champions are Kerem Tancer and Albay Azilek from Turkey.
A pair of crew members who continue to dominate, who back in 2008 and 2009 ran off 13 straight victories in a row during those two seasons. We're here in 2010 and are back again collecting more UIM hardware, ladies and gentlemen. Two racing heroes in their country, Kerem Tuncer and Albay Azilek from Turkey, the 2011 world champions in the UIM offshore class 3, 225 division. Congratulations, gentlemen.
Very good. Back for another year in the UIM offshore class 3, 225 class, Kerem Tuncer and Albay Azilek from Turkey. Thank you. And now offshore class 3C, the world champions are Michael Bengtsson and Erik Stark from Sweden.
Two Swedish drivers who raced against each other in the 2T400 class decided to join forces in a strong offshore effort, and it paid off nicely. Mikael Bengtsson, who is in the building business, ordered a new Arco cat. No testing, no paint, no worries. These two went out, became the youngest crew in the history of offshore 3C class at only 24 and 23 years of age. And now the world champions, ladies and gentlemen, for the final time this evening with these gentlemen, the UIM offshore class 3C, Mikael Bengtsson and Erik Stark from Sweden.
Thank you. Thank you to our champions, and thank you to Andrea Dini and Enrico Gelpi. And now Mr. Nicolo Di San Germano, H2O Racing President, and Mr. Gianni Merlo, President of International Sports Press Association, please join the stage with us. And we keep on talking about offshore, class 1 and class 3. The world champions offshore class 1 and class 3 are Arif Al-Zafen and Nadir Bin Hindi, along with Mohammed Al-Mari from the UAE.
This crew did a fantastic job this season under extreme pressures in some of the top levels of competition from the wild world, winning two classes and proving once again that they are a team to beat in the winning home waters to close out the competition late in this season. Ladies and gentlemen, two great sportsmen and tremendous athletes, winning both the UIM Offshore Class 1 and Offshore Class 3S titles. From the United Arab Emirates, Arif Al-Zafen and his teammate, Nadir Bin Hindi, world champions.
Great job indeed. And Steve, our final classification on the evening is UIM Nation Cup. The winner is the UAE team with Ahmed Al-Hameli and Mayed Al-Mansouri.
Well, in the newest and what may be the future of one of the most dramatic series on water, the UIM Nations Cup. Two drivers who are stars of the future were teamed together last November in Singapore and finished 1-2 in the driver standings and led Team UAE to their first UIM Nations Cup Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, Ahmed Al-Hameli and Mayed Al-Mansouri, Team UAE.
Good. Thank you, all of you champions. Actually, as we start concluding this wonderful evening, so please, all the world champions of tonight, all the guys and girls and boys that have been giving the awards tonight, I ask them to please come here on the stage with us for the final picture. And of course, we have to salute all our special people that were honored this evening. And of course, I kindly ask to Mr. President surely to join us on the stage. So please, all the champions, move from your chairs for the final picture. They simply want to keep on eating.
Gentlemen,
well,
ladies,
we could try in other languages. Allora, per gli italiani stiamo per fare la foto di gruppo finale, quindi tutti i campioni italiani che sono stati premiati, prego venire qua sul palco insieme al presidente per la foto finale, mentre le nostre ragazze, le nostre modelle si preparano con gli abiti da sera di Genou Haute Couture e anche tutti gli altri piloti. Let's say it in English.
So please, all the world champions, Vandischer Dimitri, Vandischer Roman, Yaziev Armen, Schiller Dimitri, Dudax Andreis, Andrei Leontiev, Stanislav Meter, Vladimir Svenatsov, Eris Epinkin, Sergei Krizyakev, Yuri Smirnov, Alexander Smirnov, Ivan Pilayev, Alex Giglioli, René Benke, Attila Avas, Stan Kelder, Georgi Kasimov, Anastasia Varlamova, Timofey Nikitin, Yulia Yurchenko, Maxim Pikotkin, Jerome De, Eric Dublé, Ott Joala, Martin Maros, Maximilian Tukos, Ben Jett, Christian Carlsen, Scott Liticot, Marian Jung, Eric Stark, Alex Carella, Julie Bulto, Mattia Fracasso, Jeremy Polé, Valerio Calderoni, Teddy Pons, Gianmaria Gabbiani, Maurizio Carando, Eugenio Falcon, Vittor Ribeiro, Lucio Stefani, Karen Tucher, Alpay Ardilek, Benston Mikael, Eric Stark, Mohamed Almarri.
All the champions here with us on the stage for the final.
Ahmed Alamli and Majed Almazzuri.
Thank you Andrea Dini, and thank you to Mr. President Chiuli. Andrea Dini must go for the final picture.